We could have been anything that we wanted to be. And it's not too late to change. I'd be delighted to give it some thought. Maybe you'll agree that we're really on 2, 3, 4.
Hello?
Got a gig tonight. Are you free?
Is it paid?
No, I'm afraid. No.
Go on then.
We could have been anything that we wanted to be. Yes, that decision is ours. It's been decided where we could divide it. Let friendship double up our power.
Take a look at that old man wanking at the bus stop. Sailors fisting all the little boys. Hello. All right, thanks so much for coming. How you doing? Yeah, what's your name? What's your name? What do you do for a living? What do you do? Good stuff. Hey. Like, when I first come out on stage all the time, a lot of people thinking, oh, here he is. Here he is. White, middle class, 18-year-old guy. He can't be funny. What's he got? No. But the thing is, I'm not middle class. I'm half middle class, half working class. I'm a half classed, right? And I don't even think that I'm even white. Like, I don't know who my dad is. I have no idea who my dad is. Could be anyone. Could be you. Probably not, but but it could be. It could be anyone. I don't know, right? And I think he might be black. He might be more specifically Nigerian, because I've been getting a lot of emails about inheritance. So guys, I watch a lot of porn, right? Yeah, this is going to be like an interactive bit now. That sounds weird. I do watch porn, and I watch parody porn. So like, you know, like the Avengers, but imagine then they're all just fucking each other. So that's what happens, basically. I watch a lot of that. And I've been thinking, like, maybe do a different style of parody porn. Like, you could parody anything, really, like great works of literature, like Charles Dickens, right? You could have Charles Dickens productions, and then you could have A Tale of Two Fitties, David Copperfield, and I'll have a fist as well. I'll have a fist, right? And I've thought about this a lot. So basically what happens is there's a workhouse, and Mr. Bumble is at the top of the workhouse. Now I'd just like to point out at this point, all children are played by consenting adults. So Oliver would be on the like with Mr. Bumble, right? And Mr. Bumble's just fisting Oliver in front of all the workhouse kids. He's just fisting him, right? And Oliver just goes, "Please, sir. I want some more." And Mr. Bumble goes, "More? You want more, boy? Oliver, Oliver, never before has a boy asked for more. Oliver! Oliver!" And that's what happens. And then Oliver, don't worry, gang. Oliver escapes the workhouse, right? And he tries it out on his own in London Town. In London Town, he tries to make his way as a rent boy. And he meets the artful dogger. And he goes, "Hello, Oliver! There's only one way to make your way in London. And that's selling your arse." And then Oliver goes, "Oh, well, how do you do that, artful dogger?" He goes, "It's easy. Practice. Just finger yourself at home. Finger yourself
in front of the family.
And then Oliver, you know, he starts going around on his own. Who am I, my quivering anus? He meets Fagin, and then Fagin teaches him the way of being the best rent boy in London. He's got a team of rent boys. He goes, it's easy, lads. Charlie, bring me them nose rags. He goes, in this life, one thing counts, in the bank, large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You've got to fit a cock in or two, boy. And all these guys just start rolling out, entering Fagin. You've got to fit a cock in or two. Come on. Boy. I'm reviewing the situation. And that's my Oliver Porn parody. Now, before I go, I want to tell you that I lost my granddad recently. Aww. Then we found him. Hey! Oh! 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 He was dead, though. He was dead. And he was dead. And it was sad because I'd never experienced death in my family before my granddad. He was like really close to me and I didn't know what to do. The only thing that died in my family was like a Tamagotchi when I was about 12. I don't know if you remember Tamagotchis, but they were awesome, right? They were so cool, they were banned from school. Like, everything cool was banned from school. Pogs, Tamagotchis, yo-yos, my Uncle Mike, all banned from school. But all equally as amazing. And I remember when my first Tamagotchi died, my mum said to me, Ben, do not worry. It's just my mum. She just said to me, Ben, do not worry. There is a reset button on the back. You turn it over and you press the reset button and you will get a brand new Tamagotchi. But it didn't set me up for my granddad's death very well, because it was like the only point of reference I had, so I just grabbed his corpse. Sat my finger up his bum going, come back, granddad! Come back! But there was no reset button up there, guys. Just a swollen prostate. Like, I know, it's disgusting. He didn't actually die of that. It's not that bad. He actually had 10 strokes, right? He loved his strokes. He could not get enough of them. Honestly, he loved them. He really did. I don't feel bad for him. He had a dark sense of humour, just like me. He had a really dark sense of humour, and he used to laugh at people that had strokes, like his mates and stuff. But then when he had one, he was laughing on the other side of his face. He was. He was kicking himself, guys. But with his right leg, because. I know, you're going, look, that's really out of order. That's your granddad. Look, you've got to understand about me is I didn't know my dad. I really didn't know my dad. And my granddad was like a dad to me, and I loved him so much, and he died, and it was awful. And, like, for me, I'd make jokes about him, like, just to keep him alive in my head, and it's really nice and it's great. And I hope he's up there now and he's looking down on me and he's going.
Try it, we
can even guess how much a real friend is worth.
Good guys,
shake an open hand. Maybe we'll be trusting if we try to understand.
No doubt about it, it must be worthwhile. Good friends do tend to make you smile.